Video 6, 3D data. From the previous lesson, we learned about the basic parameters in a drawing file. Today's lesson, we will help us get a 3D model used to create reinforcement model and make construction drawings. There are many ways to get a 3D model of a building. Firstly, you can import data from other 3D modeling softwares. Revit, Sketchup, or Allplan, for example. Currently for Sketchup or Allplan files, you can import directly from the source file. For Revit, we currently import IFC4 format. You choose to import, select the IFC4 format and the path of file to import. Select OK. By importing this, the 3D model with building components and reference planes will precisely match the desired coordinates. This is very common for large projects when customers send 3D models to us. At this time, we just need to import it. You can directly erect components such as foundation, walls, columns, beams, slabs for the project. For example, I built a simple 3D model here. And in fact, you can create a 3D model of your building from foundations, columns, beams, and slabs. The way of generating these components is similar. We only need to use architecture modeling tools. You will adjust the size properly on the plan view, then define the heights for each component. You can review the videos about creating walls and columns before in the architecture tutorial videos. I'll leave the links below. You'll better understand the way of modeling components. This way will be suitable for small and medium buildings and designers from the beginning of the project. Here, I also proceed in the way of self 3D modeling. I inherited from the previous architectural 3D model. However, some points have been modified to suit our drawing of rebar. Here are the 3D models I inherited from the architectural 3D model. Deleting the finishing parts, I kept only the unfinished structure parts, completing the model with single foundation system and ground beams. And you can choose to import available model or create it from the first step for your project to get your desired 3D model. Our lesson is finished here. In the next video, we will modify the 3D model to suit the requirements.